Hi boys and girls, Mike here, one go short play. Tonight we are playing Cyborg Justice for the Sega Mega Drive. Now, I've just had a crack at a game called Cyber Cop, and the other day I had a crack at a game called Cyber Police, and turns out Cyber Cop was just Corporation, and we've just seen that, so I'm not going to bother you with that again. Just go back a few videos if you need to see Corporation. And Cyber Police, turns out it was E-SWAT. They'd just taken the tagline from the title, which goes above the title. Under false impressions, the game is called Cyber Police. Everyone knows that E-SWAT. This, on the other hand, is Cyborg Justice Now. Awesome intro. It's all insinuated. You're a human, you crash on a planet, you die, they bring it back. Bit of Robocop. Awesome game. Well, in some ways a really bad game, but in other ways an awesome game. Let's not let the demo run, let's play it. Now, I've forgotten the things that make this game really good, and that's the problem with this game. The special moves and the controls are really complex. Like two buttons and then push left and whatever. And that's its downfall, really, amongst other things, which we'll get to. Cyborg Justice, look at that lovely artwork. Let's just play the game. Okay, so at the beginning of the game, you get to pick. Look at me, robot. It's a cyborg. I've got a human soul. You get to pick your arm. Now, my favourite, I know people have got their favourites on this. My favourite is that buzz cut arm, if I remember how to use it. Normal body. Now, I'm sure the bodies have more health, but slow you down. I quite like the big chunkier bodies. I like the names, though. That looks good, but then the name frog body kind of puts you off it. Big booster body sounds quite good. Quasimodo body looks great, but it's called the Quasimodo body, which isn't very endearing. I might pick it anyway. Jogging legs, spiked legs, somersault legs. Look at the animations. I love that this is all avatar parts, this robot. There's so many things about this game that are great. Oh, tank legs. I'm not sure I remember how to use them. Big foot legs. Can they make me jump higher? I think they do. Oh, pneumatic legs. Let's go with them. Okay. So, awesome. You can kind of see the appeal of this game. I've got a character that I've just built out of parts. That's a bit weird. The up and down movements. Oh, watch out for them. If you hang around too long, basically, you get rockets coming at you. Now, this weapon has got heavy attack. Oh, he's just hit me with the heavies. This weapon has got something. I think if I double tap it. No, that's not happening. Was it down and double tap? Down and press, down and... Okay, but basically, if I get this right, I can make that thing... Oh, I can't figure it out. I can make that little razor thing come out of its, thing and basically razor blade the robot to death. And the cool thing is, I'm never going to be able to do it now. The cool thing is... Oh... And you can kind of move it around and cut him up, and it's great. But yeah, the cool thing is when you knock him on the floor, when you pretty much kill them, you can start stealing their body parts. I've just been absolutely owned by the most basic attack moves. Now, when I was a kid, I used to be able to complete levels on this. And what I didn't know or realise at the time, what happens if I hit start? Oh, it pauses, okay. I think I better figure out how to... See, he's in like a pile on the floor. If I get to him quickly enough, I can get down there and steal his body parts. Let's see if I can do it. Because it's not going to happen, is it? No. Because this arm's no good to me if I can't use it. Ow. I think it was a double tap and then hold. Clearly wasn't, because he's not doing it. Oh, it's annoying. Let's look at the instruction manual. Let's see, I've totally forgotten all this. Oh, I just did it. How I did that. Oh, I did. I pulled down and jump. Okay. Pull down and jump, you can crouch. I think that means that's how you pick up, like pull the arms off and stuff. Hey, look. So you can do stuff like that. Oh, cut him off. Cut him off. Cut him off like it's a sandwich. Oh, I really want to cut him off. Oh, there it is. Oh, no. Oh. So it's down, forget that, down double tap, yeah, got it, down double tap, and there it is. Okay, see how complex that is, there's no need for how hard that was to do, but there's loads of moves in this game like that, down double tap, Oh, come on. Down double tap. Oh, he's just going to hammer me now. Yeah, there we go. Oh, I can't get him to do it properly. Have that. Oh, okay. Have that. Down double tap. Down double tap. Oh, no, he's just getting under it. But I loved this game. I thought there was so much potential. I think potential was the thing. Can I just pick up a body part there? No, I don't know how to do that now. Really, you can see the moves are really complex. It didn't go down well, this game. And I can see why. It's a bit... there's a means of doing this as well. I think I've got a... No, it's not that. Oh, I'm going to die. There we go. Oh, no. I didn't even get to do the jump. That would have been instant death anyway. it's a better game than that goat gave it credit for. Let's just pick another one, make up 10 minutes. Yeah, we'll try the laser hand day. And a different body. Try the frog body. And that pair of legs was rubbish, let's face it. Let's even do something with the tank legs. I'm sure I can't. I never have been able to use them. but yeah, me and my mate Steve used to love this. In fact, I think he had it and I borrowed it off him a few times. Double tapping down, double tapping down. I like the way they have little sensors on the heads that go off when like an enemy comes. So each weapon has got different controls to make it work. I don't know how to make this laser shoot. I'm just doing a lot of the same stuff. Double tap up. No. Down and double tap. No. Oh well, let's just get in there and start kicking. So I might have more luck doing that. I'm trying to figure out stupid moves. I love the animations. Oh, he just did it. He was about to shoot. I can just. Yes. Right, how do I pick up body parts off these? There's a really cool mechanic that you just go up and, if I could remember what it was, you just go up and grab them by the arm and rip off the arm and replace it with yours with theirs. And that was so much fun. Oh, look, he's got the blade armor on it. But I'll never get it because I'll never figure out how to. Let's see if it's pull away. And yeah, I've got it. Look. Pop. Off you come. And you can fling it or you can put it on yourself. I'm going to have that. I'm having that. Okay, can I put it on myself? No, I'm throwing it. It's dead. Oh, it's gone. It's gone, man. Right, can I pull other stuff off him? But can you see the potential? Can you see the potential of this game? I did love it. Animations are great. The thing is, people say it's not very fun, and I think it is quite fun. I think they're just wrong about that. It's a bit too quantized, as in, like, I'm waiting around while he blows up, because, you know, he's waiting for me to go and pick up parts off him. And it takes a bit too much work to learn how to play. No arm for you. I'm liking that now that I can do it. Okay, but we know that A drops it and B throws it. Right, so he's dead now because he can't put himself back together without my help. And I'm not going to help him. I don't like the up and down walk. I'm just lazy. But look at that walk. And this is all a bit Final Fight on the Amiga. You know, you have these big empty barren areas. Let's see if I can get across. I think that's it. Once you don't know how to jump across, that's it. You're dead. But I like it. I like the game. And I did figure it out back in the day, and more recently because I bought a copy for me Mega Drive because I liked it, and I think it's got the instruction book. Anyway, I figured out the controls. I think I looked online. I'm about to die. If you like brawlers and ones that are a bit of a challenge and want to take a bit of a learning curve, you know, to get good at, Cyborg Justice might be the game for you. It's very unique in many ways, and I think it would translate well to the modern gaming genres, maybe, I don't know, sort of. Brawlers tend not to these days, but that might, with all the pulling off and adding on of parts. Yeah, what someone picked up on another YouTube channel, which I never noticed as a kid, is basically, apparently every level is pretty much the same, but with a different background. And if that's true, then that really sucks. I never noticed though when I was a kid, and I didn't get more than a couple of levels in, maybe three levels in. So it felt fine to me. But yeah, if you're into these unique looking little brawlers, and I am, Cyborg Justice is definitely worth checking out. Cyborg Justice, Sega Mega Drive. Thanks for watching.